Let us discuss about series combination of resistances, elementary idea about which you already have, which you have studied in your early classes. It is a situation in which resistances are connected one after another. Series combination is the one in which, say, if we are having three resistances, one end of one resistance is connected to the other end of a second resistance and so on. This is called series combination of these resistances. Say the terminal ends of this combination are A and B. And say if this combination is connected across a battery of given EMF E, then we can say obviously due to this combination a current I will flow through the circuit. And always remember, when our resistances are connected in series, the current throughout remains same. In any electrical devices which are connected in series, the same current will pass through all the electrical devices. That is the basic characteristics of a series combination. And if a current I is flowing, then in this situation we can say the potential difference across the resistance R1 V1 we can write as IR1 according to Ohm's law. The potential difference across the resistance R2, we can write V2 as IR2. And for the third resistance also, we can write V3 as IR3. And in this situation, we can say the total potential difference applied across the terminals A and B is E. So here this total potential difference, which is the battery EMF, can be written as sum of these potential differences V1, V2 and V3. Now in this situation, we can simply write the value of E as IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. And if we wish to find out the equivalent resistance of this combination of resistances, in the previous section we have studied that equivalent resistance is written as the potential difference applied across the combination divided by the current flowing through the combination. So here it will be E upon I. And from this equation, we can find out the value of E upon I, which is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So always remember that in case of series combination, always the equivalent resistance of the combination is given by the sum of the individual resistances of the combination. If we just analyze a practical situation here, with the help of this situation, you can see in the circuit again, I'm just taking a realistic situation for the above diagram. Here you can see if in the three resistances, if we close down the switch, you can see the battery will supply a current and the same current will pass through all these three resistances one after another. In the whole circuit, in the loop, the constant current I will flow. So in this situation, we can always write that in series combination, the current in all resistances remains same. So be careful about this note, that is quite useful. And as I have already explained that even if there are many devices connected in series in a circuit, in an electrical circuit, we can say that current through all the electrical devices will remain same in series combination.